Hi students, good morning, how are you? My name is M. Don Bosco, SA Bioscience, in GHS Shantinagar, in Kamam town. Today we have discussed about the plant tissues and their functions. In the previous class we are discussing about the cells and it organelles. We are already learning about the in the cells, each cell contains the different organelles. For example, they are nucleus, plastids and ribosomes and mitochondria. Like that, so many organelles are present in the cells. Each organelle, they have the specific function in the cell. All these information we are learned in the previous class. Today we are going to learn or discuss about the tissues. What are the tissues? Do you know anybody knows what are the tissues? Yes, a group of cells is called a tissues. These tissues, they have formed as a group, but their function is a specific function. Each tissues, they have the specific function. These tissues join together, combine together to form a one organ. These organs are joined together, formed a they formed as an organism. So in the all these information we are learned in the previous classes. Today what is the special of this today class? Today we are discuss the only plant tissues. Do you know plant have they have so many parts? In the previous class, from the 6th to 6th class, 7th class, 8th class, we are already learned about the parts of the plant. Once again, we see the parts of the plants. Please recall the parts of the plants: roots, stem, shoots or branches, and leaves and flower buds and flowers, fruits and seeds. These are the parts of the plant. I am asking to you one question. All these parts, they have same cells or they have the specific cells in the all these parts of the plant? Let us see. First of all, today we are going to discuss about the cells of the root. Before going to the structure and function of the root cells, do you know plants, they are monocots and dicots? We are already in the 6th class, 7th class, little bit we are already learned about the monocots and dicots. In the root system, there are two types of root system mainly. They are taproot system. The another one is the fiber root system. This is the main taproot. The another one is the fiber root system. The fiber root system, they have the no tap, main tap roots. The bunch of small roots are formed is called as a fiber root system. This is the tap root system. The all cells are equal in the tap root system or fiber root system? Let us see, is the same or not. Today we are discussing about, mainly we are talking about and experimental, what is the functions of
roots.
Do anyone know the functions of roots?
Yes.
The main function of the roots is to absorb the minerals and water from the soil and transport the all the cells of the plant. Okay, this is the one of the main function of the roots. Some specific functions are in the roots. Some of the roots are helps to the respiration of the plants. These roots are called as a aerial roots. For example, in mangrove trees, there are the special roots. They are called the aerial roots. Whatever it may be, the main function of the roots is to absorb the water and minerals from the soil. This is the main function. Today we are once again going to the what is the structure of the cells. I am asking another question to you. All the roots are same size or same length? Is there any difference between the different plants, their roots? Do you observe the taddy or coconut tree's roots? They have the specific roots, the bunch of roots in the present in the coconut tree. These roots are called the fiber roots. Okay, the other mangoes, in our gardens, in our surroundings, we see the so many plants. These plants, they have the main root that is called the taproot. Okay, this is the main difference to the taproot and fiber roots. So today we are going to observe the root tissues and their structure and function. Before going to the observation of these roots, we conduct a small experiment. Before conducting this experiment, we choose the one onion and take the one onion, and then it is put into the one plastic or before conducting this experiment, we choose the one onion and take the glass and pour the full of the glass and to keep it like this in the onion on the glass. Keep this whole experiment in the lab or a special room. Why we have selected the onions? The onion roots are the growing is onion roots growing up is very fast, and also it is very very flexible to the observe. That's why we select the onions. We are already discussed about take this onion and select the one bottle, pour the full of water in the bottle, and they arrange like this onion in the mouth of the bottle. Keep this all equipment in the a separate room or in our laboratory. Keep this all equipment into 4 to 5 days. After 5 days, we are observe the how the roots are growing. After 5 hours, we are observing our activity. There are so many roots. After five days, we observe the so many roots are growing in the onions. See how these roots are growing. I am showing. All these are special roots, growing roots. For conducting this experiment, we need some materials. They are They are
microscope and onion and water glass and water and slides and cover slips and glycerin and petri dish and a needle, a small brush. We need this all equipment for conducting this experiment. Okay. After we select the onion, keep it in the water to observe the roots. We take the onion that we kept in the beaker before 5 days. This experiment. This is the onion already we kept in room before 5 days. We select the one root tip and cut it in small the end of the root. Now we take the one root and cut it the end of the root. See, I cut the root. This is the observe the end part of the root tip. Now let us observe the root cells from these growing rods. Now I am take out the onion bulb that we kept in the transparent bottle. Observe the root cells from these growing roots. See how the roots are growing in the onion bulbs. Now I am take out the onion bulb and that we kept in the transparent bottle. I take the one root, cut in the small tip of the root on it. The small part of the root tip. Now I am adding one drop of saffron to the root tip. Wait 10 seconds and place it on the slide. Now I am trying to place it on the slide. I am taking the one slide and place it the root tip. After that I pour the one or two drops of water. Now I am adding the glycerin solution, one drop of glycerin solution. This is the glycerin solution. After adding up glycerin solution, now I am cover the tip, cover the this tip with a cover slip. Now I am trying to remove the excess of glycerin on the slide. Now I am trying to press this root tip slightly, trying to press it with the help of the needle. Now I am placing the slide under the microscope for observation of root tip. Now I am observe the root cells in the microscope. How it is formed, all cells are formed. All are observed this. In observation, are all the cells are similar? They are not similar. They have the specific structure and specific arrangement in the structure of the root tip. Now let us observe this special structure. Now let us place this slide under microscope to observe the internal structure of the root tips. Observe the parts of the root cell. We observe different cells in different zones. These different zones of root cells, they are: one is the zone of cell differentiation, the second zone is the zone of cell elongation, and third one is zone of cell division, and last one is root cap. See, the cells in the zone of division, it gets divided into more cells, which leads to elongation of roots. Okay students, this is the internal structure of the root cells. Now we are ready to conduct the second experiment. We conduct this experiment to observe the growth of roots. All the roots growth is same or different. How can we identify? That's why we conduct this experiment. Let us see the procedure to conduct this experiment. Take the transparent glass. This is the transparent bottle and filled with the water. I am already filled with the water. Before conducting this experiment, we follow the same procedure as follows as above experiment. Mark the end of the root which we cut in the previous experiment with a marker. Now put this onion bulb in a glass beaker filled with the water. Keep this arrangement in room 4 to 5 days. Make sure that these roots of onion bulb are submerged in the water of the transparent beaker. See, after 5 days, we observe all the roots, they are grown except the root we marked. This is the because of root which we cut has a lack of cells divide. Hence it does not get elongated.
We observe the root tips and their cells. And also we observe the there are three special division of the root tips. In examination point of view, the questions will be asked like this. To conduct an experiment to observe the root tips are in your school. Then we have write like this. First of all, we write the aim. Write the aim. What is the aim? To observe the root tip cells in laboratory. That is our aim. The second one, materials or equipments. What are the materials we need to conduct this experiment? We know already what are they? Microscope, onion bulb, water, and beaker, and glycerin, petri dish, needle, brush, slide, and cowslip. We should write all these materials as stepwise. Then, after write the materials, we should write the procedure also. What procedure we follow the conduct this experiment, all these procedure we should write in the procedure column. After complete the procedure column, we should what we write? Observation. In this experiment, what we are observed? We write the in the observation column, we observe the root tips in our laboratory. There are three special zones are in the root tips. They are zone of cell elongation, zone of cell of division, and root caps and other zone. Four zones are we observed in this experiment. And also we should impression what in this experiment what we learn in this experiment we learn there are specific cells in the root tips. These cells are helped to grow the cells. Precautions. In the experiment, we take the two precautions. What are they? They are
part of the onion bulb where the roots are grown must be submerged in the water. We should take these precautions. First of all, there must not be any air bulb in between the cowslip and the slide. These are the precautions. Okay
children, this is our experiment. Thank you.
Like to thank SCRT Telangana and respected DO of Kammu and Suryapeta Sri P. Madan Mohan sir and all the technical team members and coordinators of two districts and two districts DCB secretaries, especially Kammu DCB secretary Sri Kanapati Venkateshwar sir and TBSF Kammu district president Repala Srinivas sir and PGHMs Srimati Anita Madam and Krishna Kumari Madam, my colleagues Ranjit and Evie and my daughters Lasya, Yamini, Navya for technical support. Thank you.